Good morning. Now we enter to the academic communication. We have studied some frames in the previous chapter, almost 7 frames by which we can develop your communicative skill. Now from the part of the writing skill, as well as once you have some group discussions and debates, what all the frames that you can keep in mind? That is a matter of question concerned in the textbook, page number 118. Academic communication, the first topic deals with the frame number discussion skills. Frame number 1 called discussion. How you will get a discussion? We are familiar with the group discussion. Alright, all the, professional interviews, they make a group discussion by which you will be selected who is competent enough to face the challenges of profession. Even in the professional courses called MBA, in different management colleges, we have this type of discussion. Even the very highlighting job, even for the lecturership in colleges, they have group discussion nowadays introduced. So you should be familiarized with certain steps of and certain frameworks of certain type of communications in the field of group discussion. Maybe the reason that university forced you to study this area, what is called academic communicative skills. So different stages are there, a topic will be supplied and from these topics you can talk as you witness in television channel discussions. You can put your ideas, but here think that you have to communicate in English. So for that purpose, we feel certain frames for the introductory part, the body part, and the conclusion part. That in these 3 to 4 areas, what all the frames that you will adopt to communicate? That's a matter of question coming in this field. So ask someone for their opinion. First step, step number 1, opinion step. You can copy down this opinion step. The moderator, the person convener will be there to ask certain opinion. For first frame that you can ask, what do you think? What do you think is the first frame that you can keep. What do you think? All right, for introducing a topic, may I know your opinion? All right, that is a frame. May I know your opinion? All right, may I know your opinion? Do you like to have a discussion? Do you like to have a discussion? Some people say, have you got any suggestion on this topic? So group discussion goes in this way. First we put a topic by certain methods of asking question. What do you think about? What do you think about dowry system? What do you think about love marriages? What do you think about present corruption of politicians? So people, you can introduce the topic by certain frames. First introductory step is, what do you think about? May I know your opinion? Do you like, have you got any suggestions? You know, in the group discussions, plenty of people are there, even from Malayalam medium and other out of Kerala people, Tamil people will be sitting because you are going in a professional study. Some people, though they look very, very backward in everything, will be different in speech. I have seen so many people, once we executed our public opinion programs in the colleges, unexpected candidates would come and talk in an elaborate way, so that we will wonder why this guy who was very silent, keeping outside everything, but talking too much. The impression provides he might have been trained in a well manner. You know, the maximum training is there. That is why Bertrand Russell says, no meaning in success and failure. All human beings are born equal. Even in the discussion time, plenty students are sitting. We cannot adjudge, we cannot make a judgment that this guy won't talk, this guy would talk, this guy will be eloquent. No, we cannot make. You know, what Bertrand Russell says, a person A and B running, come in, participate in 100 meter race. All right, one will be succeeded, definitely one will be successful, and one will be failed, but there is no meaning in failure and success. Russell says, two A and B are created by the same creator, and A has some more potential, so he tried his level best. On the one hand, the failed candidate also did maximum, but he did not prove to be successful. But the main effort, whatever effort A and B took, same, but somewhat maximum strength he got, he ran and got first position in running. So failure is not a word in the life. In the way, in the group discussion, we may think one person may not talk in advance, but unexpectedly he would do. This is why, what you know, there are so many stories by Buddha Sannyasis. Buddha Sannyasi one day wrote in his biographical sketches, our Siddhartha Buddha, imitating a story there. What? One old man went to a place where temporary visits and staying possible. And that time this man was wearing very shabby dress, looking like a beggar, and reaching his motel like a place where people can rest in the night. The butler means the person who runs the inn or motel, did service in a very indifferent way, because what service would be given to this man? He is wearing very ugly dress, with a very bad physical nature and all that. And somehow is out of his duty, he provided food and staying place and all that. But early morning, this old man tries to wake up early and going out. That time butler was there. This man, old man with very shabby and ugly dress, provided him a gold coin. Look here. Butler did not expect such a gold coin, such a bigger remuneration, because for such a bigger remuneration, he did not do anything. He treated him like an ordinary man. He treated him like ordinary passenger who came and take rest here, going back, but he never expected a gold coin from him. Sannyasi telling, the monk telling, after some more days and more days, all right, the same passenger, traveler, came in the same motel. Butler was there. On this day, he saw this man sometimes ago came and gave me a gold coin, which was almost 50,000 rupees, one sovereign. And now he looks very good dressed and all that. Suppose we do maximum service on him, sometime he would give me 2-3 gold coins. Expecting so many gold coins, butler Monk says, butler does service everything in an appreciable way. Very good meals provided, very good room provided, all the facilities provided. But in the following morning, the time going out, the same traveler gave a small coin, which was very, very copper coin, not that much valuable for a gold coin. He gave only copper coin, very valueless coin. Butler wondered, what? I did a very small service in the former years, former days. You gave me gold coin, and now I expect so many things. All right, I did the maximum for you, but you provide me very copper coin. What is it, man? Traveler reported, the gold coin I gave you for today's service charge. The copper coin today I give you for the previous day's service charge. Means what? Monk says, we can never make an assessment on such a person, would never talk. Anybody can talk who is trained enough. We cannot make an assessment on a person who is wearing a shabby dress, is very poor. So in the way, Hobbiji says, Monk says, person to be made assessment of by the way of conversation, whether he is literate, whether he is educated or not. In the same way, in the group discussion we sit together, we would discuss. Then there are certain frames. First introductory talk, what our opinion, what do you think about? May I know your opinion? Then give opinion. Alright, second stage, this is asking opinion. Alright, you will ask opinion. Second step, give opinion. Alright, you will write give opinion. You will provide your opinion. By the way, frames first one. I think. This is my idea. I think. That is a phrase. If you ask me, people say, if you ask me, I would say. This is very beautiful frame. If you ask me, I would say. My honest opinion is, all right, to be frank. Some people say, to be frank, I would say my opinion. So, which all the frames we can use for giving opinion? I think. If you ask me, I would. My honest opinion is that, to be very frank. Then we go to third step. So introductory part over, then we go to our opinion, bring someone into discussion. Third step, to discussion. All right, discussion. How do you reach into discussion? This is what I think. What about you? Does Raju have a different opinion? The moderator can ask anybody. Does Raju have a different opinion about that? We shall glad to know what Arya thinks of this. We shall be glad to know what Roy thinks about it. Moderator can ask. So that we can answer our spontaneous answer to the question related. Then after this discussion, we'll go to conclusion. Alright, conclusion level. What all the things that we say to sum up? We people say to sum up. To summarize the whole thing. People say to summarize the whole thing. Some other people say, in short, we can say. This you can copy around these points. In short, we can say. Even in the IELTS exams, you have to write general essay topic in argumentative way, where you will say, to the end of the essay, we say, a technical word they use, to recapitulate. A technical word you can use. To recapitulate means in nutshell, in conclusion with. I am going to conclude. Recapitulate. In conclusion, we can see like that. So, first we are provided a topic. We have to divide them into four areas of discussion. First one, introduction. Second one, we ask opinion. Then third one, we ask discussion. Then we make a conclusion. From these four topics, certain different frame structures that you study by heart, things will be so easy. So that you will never be inhibited to attend a group discussion. So keep in this mind. Again, I tell you, first one, introductory mark, asking certain frames, then opinion, then we give a group discussion in detail, then to conclude. At the same time, free academic framework number 2, after discussion, we reach frame number 2, what is called contrasting and concluding. You have to add what all the phrases you can ask, what all the areas that you can use for this contrasting and adding. First one, easy method, that everything given in the textbook you can copy down. All right, first one is to begin the topic. Topic number 1, to begin the topic. All right, first one, to begin the topic for discussion. Moderator can easily ask you to begin the topic. I would like to begin. All right, first frame that you study by heart. I would like to begin. This is the phrase that you study. I would like to begin. All right, the second step. All right, second step, ordering. Ordering, you have to keep order. What do you say? First of all, I must say, this is a frame. All right, first of all, I must say. First of all, I must say. Introduction, new point. The next issue, all right, the next point. Introduction. All right, introduction. Topic you have to introduce. All right, then the next issue I plan to focus on. All these are given in the textbook step by step that you have to read. So there are certain steps by which you can organize a good group discussion, by which you are provided certain frames that you study by heart and implement. This is what we mean. Adding something, adding in addition to, it creates a large number of ideas. Then examples, contrasting, one on the one hand, or the merits and the demerits. Then generalizing, some people will put certain examples to generalize. Then we say all in all, that is a technical word, all in all. All in all. All right, all in all, on the whole. Then conclusion, it is given in page number 122 and 123, a very detailed box given with a certain how to begin the topic, how to ordering, how to introduce, how to add, given example, all the areas given. Conclusion, let me conclude. I would like to sum up. All these are the methods that you have to come across. Where you will go to, that you copy down in the old book, if you are using second-hand book, page number 122, 123, that you have to copy down all these things. Then, for the debating skills, that goes frame number 3. All right, debating. Debating, as you know, You will get two factions, A and B factions. That already has been taught in the higher secondary. Problem that you agree or does not agree. People say a topic which is in the argumentative way. A topic will be supplied. A section will be there, B section will be there. Moderator will be there and asking you to certain questions. Then you will debate. But there is, you should respect the opposition. All right, let the speaker finish the topic, then you put your ideas. So you agree with someone, you agree but partially agree, say you disagree. These are the three stages. What are the stages? One, I agree with, or you agree with, or you agree with, you agree but partially. Some people say, I disagree. Then how to you find certain stages of debates? First one, strong agreement. First step is strong agreement, that you can copy down. All right, all the debates, first one, strong agreement. All right, first step is strong agreement, where you write, I agree entirely with your point of view. You can copy down this point. Once you are in the debate, you put in this way, I agree entirely with your point of view. I am in total agreement with your stand. Some people say like that. I am in total agreement. The first win, I agree entirely with your point of view. Some people say, I am in total agreement with your stand. That is given in page number 125. Some people say neutral agreement. Neutral agreement. All right, neutral agreement. Some people say neutral agreement. I think you are right. I think we can accept your position. Some people say, I can accept. We can accept your position. But on some other hand, some people have partial agreement. Partial agreement. Look here. So, strong agreement, neutral agreement, partial agreement. Some people say partial agreement. I agree with you, but need some more time to clarify. I have some confusions, but I need some more time. Some people say strong disagreement. Fourth stage, strong. This is strong agreement. Here, strong disagreement. Strong disagreement. People say, I totally disagree with you. That is the case. I totally disagree with you. You are terribly wrong. Disagreement we can provide like by this method of communication we can put. You are terribly wrong. Then we have last stage, fifth one, soft agreement. Soft agreement. What is called soft agreement? I am sorry, I can't. Soft disagreement, disagreement. This is strong disagreement. This is strong, soft disagreement. What is soft disagreement? I am sorry, I can't support. I know that whatever you are talking is okay, but I cannot easily, stop. Then we have interrupting someone, some people. So these are the stages you keep in mind. Under frame number 3, we have to keep interrupting someone. All right, interrupting. Interrupting someone. All right, someone. Once people talk and continuously talking, we will interrupt. Sorry to interrupt, you missed a point. Some people, X is talking and talking and talking. Why interrupting and telling? You missed a topic. You missed a point there, like that. Commanding. Next stage is commanding. All right. You can put commanding. You put your commanding spirit. I wonder I could comment on this part. I wonder I can comment. Then asking confirmation. Next one is asking, all right, confirmation from the moderator. You put asking confirmation. If I have understood you correctly, then accepting a compromise. We see no objection to that. Compromising stage. You will get the compromising stage. compromising stage. All these are given step by step in the textbook. You have to go through that and get. Then rejecting the comparison, we are not convinced in this matter. After discussing all these things, after covering all the time of and pointing your things, rejecting your compromising. All this compromise can be rejected. Reject compromising. All right. Means what? We are not really in the debate, in the towards end of the debate. Whatever you said may be correct, but from our part of point of view, what you said is not good. I cannot easily compromise you. We are not convinced in this matter. Whatever you talk in this thing, that we cannot easily agree what you talk. So many problems are given there for your, again, 127 last exercise, as in the previous one, 1 to 5 jumbled orders of words given, you have to put in the order. That is the matter. Meanwhile, you can prepare a debate on whether, dowry system is a social evil in this society. All of you prepare an assignment on this matter and send it to my personal mail ID, for which I will send you ID later. So your topic is a debate, discussion, panel discussion, which all the frames that you studied here to be placed, then write in 2-3 pages, all right, and as an assignment, send it to my mail ID. I will correct, because assignment writing is compulsory for your internal examination. So send. Topic is whether dowry system is social evil or not. Is it in your point of view, whatever material you collect from others, so many internet site available, or in the school or college level essay topics available, you go through the what is called a dowry system, whether it is considered to be social evil or not. You prepare as such, then send it to me mail ID. Till that, our transition 2 modules totally over, then we will do certain revision work later. Revision work means going through all the exercise, we will dictate the correct answer and you can copy down. And also you try to get the textbook from the store, then only you can follow me in the correct way. Till that moment, thank you very much.